The message at Canadian Overseas Petroleum, a TSXV listed company, is that they're looking for early success in 2014. Let's talk now to the president and chief executive, Arthur Millholland. 2014 seems to be the year that you guys are working towards. What's cooking?
Well, what's cooking is that we have a joint venture with Exxon Mobil in a deep water block offshore Liberia in equatorial Africa to drill a very significant exploration target that we've mapped out on seismic, working on for a number of years. We're quite excited about it. And it's right now is one of the exploration hotspots on this earth.
What a partner. Can't get much bigger.
No. There's nobody else like them in size.
The other thing about Liberia is it's interesting is that you're just one of just a couple of small companies there. Everyone else are the big boys, aren't they? I mean, what are the prospects in this area?
What's attracted the super majors to Liberia? Chevron is there as well, and large independents like Anadarko, is that this is a basin where there's a known hydrocarbon system, light oil. It's not a gassy basin, it's an oily basin, and with a very thick sedimentary package. And that being said, is there, this potential for very large stratigraphically trapped oil accumulations, and analogous to what's been found offshore Ghana.
Independent broker Edison says that what you've got planned for early 2014 could unlock substantial value. How would you describe the possibilities?
Well, we're carried by Exxon Mobil for 17% until they spend $120 million in drilling costs, and that's just drilling costs. We're carried for all kinds of other costs through them. But what it unlocks is if you look at the potential, and our independent evaluator, has given a probability of finding between a 90% probability to a 10% probability, between 1.8 billion and 4.2 billion barrels of potential recoverable oil, that at a 17% interest, that's substantial, and would give us a net potential exposure to between 300 and 700 million barrels of oil. Now, if you give a valuation on that, and what do you think of it as in the ground at an appropriate discount rate, but at $5 to $10 a barrel, if it's at $10 a barrel, that's between $3 and $7 billion of potential. And we have 300 million shares outstanding, so I think you can do the math.
Talking about doing the math on things, what's your cash situation at the moment? You just produced third quarter results, I know. What have you declared there?
We've had just under $5 million in cash, and because our third quarter was just recently released. That will take us through the drilling of the well. But that being said, is we've got a very small but very talented technical team, evidenced by bringing Exxon into this project in Liberia, and we're looking at other things. So, you raise capital when you need to raise it, and if you have a good reason to do it. But right now we're not desperate for capital.
And also you're looking at assets outside Liberia. I think you're going to Nigeria, aren't you? Is that right?
Yes, we're looking at projects offshore Nigeria. We're a group that's been together for a number of years, and we're very comfortable working offshore. Even though that originally I started working land-based operations, and Nigeria is a country that has been blessed with great oil resources and gas, and the issues there are country risk versus we'll call it geologic risk, and we believe that we, a group with our skill set, can bring skills to say a Nigerian company. Who has interest in acreage, and it's a good way to combine our skill set with their position. The benefits work out well for everyone.
One final question is about the company. You're looking for listing in London, aren't you?
Yeah.
What's all that about?
Well, it's all about liquidity. There's always a continuing debate, and you hear it here, about private companies versus public companies, and when to go public, and the public markets, right now, may not be friendly towards exploration. Well, everything goes in cycles. But the key thing is to offer liquidity. And if you're going to, as a believer in the public markets, which I am, is that you need the liquidity to attract capital. And you need liquidity from an institutional investor standpoint and a retail investor standpoint. And here in the UK, for example, what I believe is one of the largest untapped markets here in the UK is the retail investor. We're used to having, as in Canada, a thriving retail market, which we have half our register is retail in Canada. But a country of 66 million people versus 35, when you've got a betting parlor on every street corner that you can go bet on a horse, well, why not go bet on a stock?
Yeah.
And so it's liquidity is what we're after.
Arthur, thanks for joining us. Arthur Millholland, the Chief Executive and President of Canadian Overseas Petroleum.